American men are stuck in what's been dubbed a friendship recession, with 20% of single men now saying they don't have any close friends. And more than half of all men report feeling unsatisfied with the size of their friend groups.
That's just a little bit of what was discussed in a recent PBS report on this epidemic of male loneliness, which I think we've all heard at least something about before the pandemic, but exacerbated by the pandemic. It is an issue of social isolation that nobody, no group is necessarily immune from, but men in particular seem to be very hard hit by it. And there are a few new developments in technology in the digital age that might help a little bit, and we're gonna discuss them, but let's go to just a little bit more about the issue.
Sometimes as men, we struggle to say, I need you.
Richard Reeves is the author of Boys and Men, Why the Modern Male is Struggling, Why It Matters, and What to Do About It.
What is driving male loneliness? Why do men have such a hard time forming friendships and keeping them as they progress through life?
You can't neglect a friendship and expect it to just grow. You have to work at it. You have to find the time. And my observation is that many women are just better at doing that and building it into their lives.
So look, we don't want to paint too dark of a picture. There are some things that people are doing to try to deal with this. Support groups, friendship groups, hobby related groups are being set up, and some men are finding a lot of success with that. But we've also seen online discussion about a couple of other ways that men are dealing with loneliness in this era. One is through the use of OnlyFans, which you probably think of as being a source for videos and photography and stuff like that, which it is, but it's also a place for some men to message with and involve in a long-term sense, in some cases, a kind of relationship with personalities online. And Business Insider has a great report on the topic that you should definitely look into. It is very big money for certain creators communicating for months or years at a time with some of these men, but some men are finding companionship through that. And I would also like to just let you know about something that I noticed in the news in the last day. It is that ChatGPT, run by OpenAI, now has a place for people to upload their own customized chatbots. And what do you know, a lot of them are AI girlfriends. There is a lot of attempts by OpenAI to shut those down, to block them, but they keep popping up. And I would speculate that they keep popping up because there is a demand for them. That it might be easier for some men to develop a sort of relationship, a lower stakes, less risky relationship with one of these AI bots than getting out there into a world that might seem very difficult. So we've thrown out a lot of stuff against the wall. What do you all make of this?
It's very sad. We don't raise men in this country. We raise boys, guys, homies, players, and dudes. And empathy is viewed as a weakness. And we are in a time when a lot of guys are finding dignity in right-wing chat rooms. When a lot of guys are finding the illusion of connection in fake women or women they pay to find them interesting, as opposed to the old-fashioned way of going to strip clubs and paying them to find you interesting. So I think the very fact that we're talking about it as a culture is the healthiest thing we can do, because it is the sort of thing that no leader, no organization can fix. It comes down to the individual who gets tired of living like this and wants to get out of his house, take a damn dance class, take an improv class, be out in the world, challenge yourself, be scared for 5 minutes, meet new people, grow a little bit, and see what kind of world is waiting for you. I don't think ridiculing these guys is the way we're ever gonna have any healing, fun though that might be. But I also get more down than the friendship deficit when I read how many young men aren't having sex. And that's what scares me. Because when men stop trying to impress women, men stop trying to be better men to impress women. I mean, we will never know how many awful men have become decent, righteous, empathetic, evolved people because of the love of a good woman or a good guy. And I fear that we've confused happiness with pleasure. Dopamine with serotonin. The brief little squirt of pleasure that you get in your brain from porn, a lot of people think that's real happiness. But it's a very brief, transient thing. And this is gonna be a phase of human evolution where we're gonna have to learn that trying to connect with each other this way, it might work a little, but it's not gonna replace being around actual people. And it's gonna make guys meaner.
Yeah, I definitely hear you. There's a temptation to laugh at people who are feeling atomized, who are feeling alone. And I think that phenomenon certainly isn't new. I mean, Robert Putnam's Bowling Alone was like one of the best books of the past couple
decades.
We
used to be a nation of joiners.
Yeah, and we don't have that. Everyone's isolated, everyone's atomized. I think that got worse over the past decade and a half, especially when you add social media, which gives you the feeling of connection.
Yeah.
And this isn't just tied to porn or OnlyFans or anything like that. Like that, I think, is a different type of need they think is being fulfilled. But I found myself often in quarantine thinking I had a healthy social relationship, because it's like friends and I would play video games every night and hang out on Discord and in voice chats. And it's like, it's kind of the same thing. But over time, after a few months, it's like, oh my God, I haven't talked to anybody at all in months. And I think that is deeply troubling and concerning when you have potentially millions of young men who are coming to a certain age in their life, or they're reaching adulthood, their views are just being shaped, and you have, unfortunately, a lot of people on the left ridiculing them, and a lot of people on the right just waiting to exploit them.
Waiting.
Yeah.
And they just pull them over. Oh yeah, all your problems, it's women. All your problems, it's immigrants, it's people of color, it's this, it's that.
Yeah.
It's not, look at this system that you're living within that atomizes you deliberately.
I had an author on my show who wrote a book about flat earth believers. And the thing about it is, the white supremacist groups zero in on conspiracy theories like this that might attract lonely people looking for community somewhere, because they know that's where the pickings are to get new people to join the master race.
Yeah.
So that's what really scares me, the illusion of dignity because you have a sudden group of friends. I just want a lot of these young men to be in a situation where they can have hugs. Because physical touch is what angry, mean men need.
Yeah.
And honestly, I don't know when we stopped trying to impress girls and trying to get out of the house and be more well-rounded and more charming and more evolved. But now, in the era of it's quicker and cheaper than a date to just watch a 5-minute porn film, this is what we're facing.
Scary. There's less anxiety and stress at the prospect of it as well. It has always been difficult to try to find a person, both for a friendship and for a romantic relationship. Those are difficult, and now there are easily available, less scary alternatives to it.
Yeah.
And you know, everything is going to, you know, flow in the direction of the least resistance, and that's kind of what it is. And the issue, like, there's so much structurally, I think, that is causing this. But then on top of it, and it deserves more conversation, there are a lot of theoretically sources for male improvement. People who are trying to fix, you know, trying to deal with this, trying to diagnose it. You talk about authors that you have in your show. The most high profile ones are men, generally in right wing media, men in like seduction and stuff, who have no interest whatsoever in any of these men ever improving.
Correct.
Because if they improved, they wouldn't have to watch your content all day long. They draw you in to break you. Because a broken man will watch their content and buy their classes and all of that. And that cannot be said enough. They are being preyed on by really weak men who want their viewers to be even weaker, and it needs to end.
But that's beauty magazines. Men are finally catching up with beauty magazine culture because Cosmo has to make you feel inadequate and fat and uncoordinated, because if you start feeling good about yourself, you're not gonna read Cosmo.
Yeah.
And it's the same thing with guys. We're witnessing it now.
I mean, at the very least, Cosmo never said we should be gunning people down at the border.
Correct.
Like, unfortunately, that's where this often turns on the right wing version.
Absolutely. But you know, I mean, porn is to actual sex what pro wrestling is to actual sports. And if you're gonna be too scared to go out there and risk failure, if you're gonna be that much of a coward in the face of life, you're gonna stay home and play it safe with pixels on a screen. Well, I want you to have a happy life. I don't want you to be a right-wing incel resenting people and blaming women for not acting like the women in porn, you know, how women are supposed to act. And I deal with these guys all the time, and they are being warped, and they still need love, they still need to grow. And yeah, you know, it's tempting to make fun of them because some of them are so damn mean. But I still live in hope that these guys can get off of their screens, come out of their parents' basements, live in their community, and discover a little bit of empathy, and maybe learn how to spell your correctly. Just maybe.
Thanks for watching. If you become a member, you get to watch all this ad-free, except for, of course, this ad. Still, hit the join button below.